Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you my full wash day with Innersense Organic Beauty, one of my absolute favorite lines. First, I start with the Pure Harmony Hair Bath. I'm going to use about a quarter size amount for all of my hair, starting by massaging it thoroughly into my scalp, working it down my strands, and then I'm going to rinse. I'm speeding up to this because I have full faith that you all know how to wash your hair. But again, scrub your scalp, work it down your strands, and rinse it out. Now I'm just gonna squeeze out a little bit of the excess water as I apply this conditioner next. I don't want the conditioner just to run off of my hair with all of that water dripping out. Now it is obviously still soaking wet, but giving it a little bit of a squeeze helps me salvage some of the conditioner. I'm gonna pump about a palmful into my hand. Not a ton comes out with each pump, so you see me pumping about 8 to 10 times to give me the desired amount. Now from here, I'm gonna show you the several ways that you can work conditioner into your hair. I'm gonna start by coating my hair with the product, just to get it nice and saturated, all the way up through the back. I'm gonna comb my fingers through this to help detangle. I did dry brush my hair before I started this wash day, which makes this detangling process a little bit easier for me. Now once I've done that, I'm going to squish to condition. You can also massage your hair. I've heard that works just as well. By habit though, I'm gonna continue to squish and work that product out and rinse. After rinsing again, you're gonna see me give my hair a good squeeze to get a bunch of that water that's sitting in my hair out of my hair. I'm moving now into my Sweet Spirit Leave-In Conditioner. I'm gonna use several pumps of this to give myself about a quarter size amount to distribute throughout my hair. This is a spray leave-in conditioner, so you can spray it directly on your hair, but I find that it's easier to control by pumping directly into your hand. I'm emulsifying this in my hands to make it easier to distribute and working it through my hair, similar to how I worked in my conditioner. Give it some good squishing, make sure it gets all the way back up behind your ears. Now I'm moving to the I Crave Volume. I use this in place of a cream. While it is called a lotion, it does come out as a clear, slippery liquid. This is excellent for detangling and is very slippery. I use about a quarter size amount of this as well. It's kind of hard to see because it's clear, but I'm going to emulsify this in my hands as well. And I'm going to distribute this through my hair. Again, the same way that you saw me working the other product, such as the leave-in and the conditioner, into my hair. This will help me fully saturate each strand. All right, on to the fun part, how I get my curls to clump and how I avoid that messy section in the back of my head. What I'm doing is brushing that side to the side, the front to the front, and the other side down to the side. What I am not doing is brushing the hair from the nape of my neck over my head. The reason I don't do that is because once my hair starts to solidify and dry with the product in it, the hair is going to want to bend up. That creates that messy section in the back of my head, which I like to avoid. Now I'm going to do the roping section, where I rope my hair into two halves and I give my head a gentle shake. This whole process I call brush, rope, shake. Pretty simple. Now I'm taking my finger and I'm naturally separating curl clumps where they want to separate, where it might have been splitting at the top but stuck together at the bottom. I'm also taking those larger sections apart because they take a really long time to dry and I just don't prefer very big curl clumps. Now that I've got the clumps the size that I prefer them, I'm going to begin squishing out the excess water. I like to do this before applying gel because it decreases my dry time. You'll also see me swirling some of them into my hand and clapping out the excess water to help them shape a little bit better. Now I'm going to use this cotton t-shirt to microplop, which is essentially me using the shirt to squeeze out the excess water. Lastly, you'll see me pat my roots up behind my ears, mostly because the porosity on my hair is a little bit different there than it is the rest. Now I'm going to use the I Create Hold Styling Gel. This is an all-time favorite of mine for a hard hold styler. I use about 3 pumps emulsified in my hands using praying hands for each half of my hair, and I squish it in. This coats really nicely, as most of the product does end up getting distributed into my hair and off of my hands, which I'll attempt to show you in a moment. Continue to squish that in, as I said, 3 pumps for each half. hands are clean of product. I'm going to use a few more pumps, about three, and coat all over. You also see me giving a gentle shake to the back of my hair to help it lift off of my scalp. For me, this is one of the few gels that once I scrunch it in, my hair starts to curl up fairly quickly. Now, I'm going to quickly show you a second option for helping lift your hair off of your scalp so that it doesn't dry there. I've seen a lot of curlies do this with a lot of success. Some don't like to because it can break up curl clumps, but it's a good option. Roll your head back, give it a shake, and then roll it forward. Simple as that. All right, on to drying. You could certainly air dry, but you'd have to figure out a way to roll your hair back and keep it that way. But I, as you know, prefer to diffuse. Specifically, I prefer hammock diffusing. I have a full video with instructions on how I do this and why in a separate video called hammock diffusing. Now that my hair is dry, 100% dry, I'm gonna scrunch out the crunch using a little bit of the iCreate Lift volumizing foam. I pump about a ping pong size ball into my hand. That's about a pump and a half. I'm going to work it into my hands so that I can evenly distribute this into my hair. I like to flip my hair upside down and work with it upside down since that's how I've mostly been working this entire time. There's a couple of ways that you can scrunch out the crunch. You can do it how I was just showing you, which is scrunching your hair. You can also use praying hands if you have any stubborn pieces, especially those thinner curl clumps that don't want to let go of that product. Using a firm praying hand generally will help break that up pretty easily. Now I'm going to show you how I break the cast up if any product has gotten near my roots. I like to curl my fingers in and then open up my palm. Do this especially on the back of your head. Again, if you struggle with getting the messy section in the back of your head, this is a really nice way to help break up that product. Now from here, I'm just going to use my fingertips to help fluff up my roots and give myself a little bit more volume and lift. I try to avoid doing this aggressively as it can break up those really nice curl clumps. I'd prefer to use my fingers to break apart any large curl clumps that I want to be a little bit smaller and to give me more volume. Now I'm going to grab my wide tooth comb and just comb through the roots a couple of inches. Again, this helps remove any hair that's sticking to my scalp, but gives me a little bit more lift. This also can smooth down your root just a little bit if you prefer that smoother, softer look. Here you're just gonna see me looking around, assessing my hair, looking at any curl clumps that I might wanna break up. Again, I don't like my clumps to be too big. They create really uniform sections of waves in my hair and I don't prefer that look. Now, I'm gonna turn around and show you that there is no messy section in the back of my hair. Because I brushed my hair where it wanted to fall, I shook my roots a little bit, my hair did not dry where it didn't want to dry. Now from here, I would say let your hair settle, which means giving it about 10 to 15 minutes to decide where it wants to fall and where your part feels most natural. And that's it. That's how I use Innersense. I hope this has been helpful. Thanks, guys.